H2K Infosys provides world-class online IT training, staffing, and software testing solutions to customers worldwide. H2K Infosys, how we are different from our competitors. 100% job-oriented training, hands-on project work, cloud test lab, resume preparation and review, mock interviews, robust syllabus, one-time fee and lifetime access to classes, access to recorded sessions of live classes. H2K Infosys has won the trust of thousands of students worldwide. For a free demo class, visit us at h2kinfosys.com.
Hello? Can anyone hear me? Hello?
Yes, who is this?
This is Uma.
Hi, Uma.
Hi. I heard that you were all discussing Unix commands, right?
Yeah.
So it was a cat command that you were discussing about, right?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, I'd like to add something there. Can I?
Okay, please go ahead.
Yeah, cat followed by the file name, it will display the contents of the file. And then cat followed by the one greater than symbol and then the file name will actually open an existing file, or if the file is not there, it will create that file and open it for any contents to be typed in it. Like you can then, you know, the dollar symbol doesn't, the prompt doesn't appear after that. So you can type something in that and then you press Control D, then that will close the file. And then the cat followed by the double greater than symbol and then the file name, it's actually used to open the existing file and edit it, like you can add more contents to it. This is my understanding, so I just wanted to share that. Okay, thank you.
Yeah, thank you.
Kala, is this for the interview for QA? Hello?
Hello, are you there?
Do you hear me?
Yes, Kalai.
Yeah, you can see my screen.
Yeah, we can see your screen. Kalai, is this for the interview questions for the QA position?
Yes. Yeah, okay. I got some 6, 7, some 25 questions are there. One second. I'm not able to see the questions. Same thing. You can see the questions now, just on the screen.
We can see the questions currently.
Yeah, okay. The first question is like a shell programming, but I understood only little bit, and little hard for us. We need to read more, I think. So if you guys have any idea, we can share it. Construct pipes to execute the following jobs. They have some 5 questions. Output of who should be displayed on the screen with the value of total number of users who have logged in, displayed at the bottom of the list. Is anyone understand this question?
Yeah, for Unix, like there should be a server. Mm-hmm. All users are clients. So for one server, how many people are connected to that server? Maybe that is the one. I don't know exactly, but it's my understanding.
Output of who should be displayed on the screen with the value of source.
Yeah. Usually, like when we are entering into Unix, like programming, so we have to connect to server first. Then we have to create our username and password. So like one client is like one user here.
Mm-hmm.
So how many people, like you and me and some others, are connecting to the same server? So some people or managers want to know like who are connected to the server. So that displays that okay. users list.
Okay. That is the command that will give who, right? Dollar followed by who?
Yeah, yes.
Yeah, yes.
Okay. The next one is output of ls should be displayed on the screen. And from this output, the lines containing the word poem should be counted and the count should be stored in the file. It's like a little bit short shell programming, I think. I'll try to read the question. I understood, but I don't know how to say it here. Output of LS should be displayed on the screen. And from this output, the lines containing the word poem should be counted and the count should be stored in a file. To count the word, we have to use the command named WC followed by space minus L. It will count the number of lines in the file. And it will be, the count will be stored, number of lines in the file stored in the name, some file. And the syntax is ls pipeline. We need the pipeline operator, like one line, the lexical line thing. Pipeline operator, wc space minus l. And greater than symbol, you have to give the file name. I think if anyone try to understand and give the answer.
With my understanding, it says the output of is. That means the command is right? Is poem.
Yes. LS and sorry.
LS poem means the it will count the number of words that says the poem as a word. It will count the number of words.
Okay, yeah.
And then it gets stored in a file. So which file name it will get stored? We need to mention the file name?
I think so. Yeah, we need to mention. And whichever line has poem, that one only is counted and the count should be stored in a file.
Yeah, that's right.
Yeah, and yeah, that is in WC space minus L. That is the syntax to count the number of lines. L. So maybe we'll try to I'll try to bring the exact answer. No, I'm not getting it. Next, third one is contents of file 1 and file 2 should be displayed on the screen and this output should be appended in a file. So can you know the syntax command for this? Contents of file 1 and file 2 should be displayed on the screen and the output should be appended in a file. Appended means we'll use the double greater than symbol, adding and putting in the different things. I think catch file 1, file 2, double greater than symbol, and file name. So maybe it is maybe new file, maybe file 3. So the file 3 is the file name. So file 1 content and file 2 content is going to be appended into the file 3. So the command will be like catch file 1, file 2, double greater than file 3. So is understood? This is the answer, I think.
Maybe if you can write the answer next to the question now.
Yeah, okay. Yeah.
Maybe shall we type in. I think
file, maybe the read only file.
Yeah, maybe a file only.
That is a half part of question, right? And there is some more missing.
From output of the LS, the lines containing poem should be displayed on the string along with the counter. LS containing the poem should be displayed on the string along with the count. Some questions are not so good. They didn't form the correct.
Do we have to really use these commands in testers like in company?
Yeah, I think they're asking for us only, beginners only, I think. I heard first.
Oh.
This, the first question is a little bit confusing for us, like related with the shell program, small, simple shell program. It's continuous still. I think not much, but we know the basics of the commands, what the how you can list, how you can display the files like that. Those only they use, but not clear these questions.
But this looks like more than what they taught us, right? I mean, little confusing.
Yeah, little bit, maybe. Yeah. That's what I started with.
I know. Because we were not taught this deep, in the class, so I'm like really confused.
Yeah.
There are so many other things to learn.
Skip the first question. And
yeah, I think we should skip the hard ones because that's making us more nervous.
Second question is, explain the following comments. I think we know LS greater than file 1. Anyone say what is that? What will it do? The second question, first comment.
It displays the file 1 contents.
Okay, yeah. That's it. LS lists whatever in the file. Then banner hyphen greater than message.
Yeah, it displays like a banner hyphen that message it displays.
Yeah, hyphen is the
like a banner.
Yeah, whatever you write, type following the banner, it will be displayed, and they're storing in the message file name to call message also.
Yeah.
And third command is chat. Pair 3, pair 4, and pair 5. And double greater than report. So anyone knows what it would do?
No.
It will append the commands, the files from the... Oh, is that a file name or a parameter kind of thing?
I think it's a parameter kind thing, I think. So whatever we are giving here, it will be appended to the file named report, pair 3, pair 4, and pair 5. It may be a file or parameter. Whatever we are giving here, this will be added, appended. Appended means adding into the file named report.
Okay.
Yeah. And
report is a file, and part 3, part 4, part 5 are also three files. Those three files are appended into report file, right? You are saying?
Yes. It's left to one, left to right. First pair 3 will be appended, then pair 4, then pair 5.
Okay, thank you.
I have a question here. Mm-hmm. I thought cat is followed by the double greater than symbol immediately. Mm-hmm. And I'm confused about the command here. I thought cat follows by the double greater than symbol and then the, report or whatever. So what is pair 3, pair 4? What is it exactly, sir?
These are the thing like data or file or anything you are going into. This is called source like that. So we are going into, moving into the report. You are going to add. Actually, here we are appending because double greater than symbol, we are appending to the file named report.
Okay.
These are the data like input source. We are going to move or remove the data from pair 3, pair 4, pair 5 to the report.
Okay. Okay. Thank you.
Yeah. Next one is a cat file 1 greater than file 1. So is there anyone knows this, what is it? Into?
It's a concatenation of file. Oh.
Yeah, it will overwrite. So whatever a file 1 greater than file 1. So whatever it may, it will overwrite whatever in file 1. Whatever now the file, they gave the same name, right? Now we have some data in this left hand side file 1. If you're displaying with the same file name 1 means whatever data already there, they are going to overwrite it. It won't save the bring the back old data. new data will be there. Only if you put double greater than symbol, the data will be appended. Only one greater than symbol, one greater than symbol means it is going to overwrite the data file. Yes, understood.
Okay.
Yeah.
Yeah. So say for example, it may be the different name means maybe you can understand easily. Cat file 2 greater than file 1. Say if you change the number, maybe we can change the symbol a little bit. File 2 greater than file 1 means file 2, whatever data in file 2 is going to be stored in file 1, but the file 1 data will be erased. It won't be there. Data will be the latest data only there. Overwritten means we can't see the old data. If you use the single greater than symbol with the cat, that is the difference. Overwriting.
Hi. Could you please explain the third one more time? I didn't get it. I'm sorry.
Yeah, it's sure. Cat pair 3, pair 4, and pair 5, double greater than report. This pair 3, pair 4, pair 5 are data. This will be added into your file named report. Suppose report file has some 10 lines, already some data will be there. Whatever you can, if you have the command in it, you can try and this thing. Just type something, some 3-4 lines. Then if you have give the pair 3, pair 4, pair 5 are the, it may be a different file or different data. It all will be going to added into your file report. Appended one by one. First pair 3, then pair 4, and pair 5.
Okay, thank you. I got it.
Next is date who. This command, anybody knows what it will do?
I think it displays the current date from the system, right?
Yes, yes, yes. And date. A semicolon, this is a syntax, who greater than log file.
Will it bring the log file date?
Yes, or log file, but I'm not much sure about what log files will do.
Or the date might be, the current date will be saved in the log file, or I didn't get it completely.
Yeah, hold on a second.
Blade, can anyone just review question one in a few lines? Question one is little hard, so we kind of skipped it and came to the second question.
I couldn't understand it.
Yeah. Date who means just it will display a date and who on the screen, who is logged in the screen.
Okay.
And date semicolon who greater than log file. And date is displayed and the who is whatever display later it will be going to the log file. Log file it will be stored in the log file. Who means who logged into the system. And if you put the parenthesis, if you put, it will store both the data, what is the date and who is logged in, data, the information will be going to the log file. That is the grouping. If you use the parenthesis, that is the grouping. Two commands will be executed and it will be stored in the log file as well as displayed on your screen too. If you're not putting the parenthesis, date will be displayed on the screen. Whichever statement executed last, that output will be stored in the log file. If you open the log file, you can see the data, whoever logged in the and the current date, like that data. You guys understood? Date, semicolon, who, it is combining the statements. At a time, it will execute the date and who, and so result will be stored in the log file. If you're not putting the parenthesis, it will display only the last statement whichever the compiler executed, that will be stored in the log file. And if you put the parenthesis between then it the both the results, both the statement, the command results will be stored in the log file, date as well as the who logged in, who, whose output, whose semicolon is operated to command the statement, command the two different statement or two different commands. You got it? Anything else you have doubt now, you can ask me. I know I can say her little slower or date, semicolon, who, it will display date as well as who, whose output, who means who is logged into the currently, like that, it will display it on the screen only. If you put the file name greater than log file is the file name. So date will be displayed on the screen and whose output, who is the, currently who is in logged in, that detail will be stored in the log file. If you put the parenthesis, then it will be combinedly executed and both the date's output and whose output will be stored in the log file. If you don't put the parenthesis, the statement which is executed last, that output only goes into the log file, directed into the log file. Date will be only displayed on the screen. It won't be on the log file. That is the difference, parenthesis and no parenthesis. Guys, you guys understood? Or?
Yeah, can you give an example of which one would be used when, what you're looking for?
Yeah, if suppose it's just date and who is only the thing needed for the, suppose the manager or your team lead, whoever logged into the system in the day. So they will give the command in the cell, command date, comma, who, semicolon, who, and greater than log file, if they give, and they will see that information in this file, well, who are all logged into the server from the morning or what. From the date, who is logged in, that will be, they can look it in the log file. The details will be in the log file. So this is the most useful command, date, semicolon, who, greater than log. Other thing, just to display the information, the date, semicolon, who means, the date will be on the screen and who logged in into the server, that one only is stored in the log file. The last command is a useful command for the people who are involved in the project. Whoever, team lead or manager, whomever it may be. For us, we will know the, just if you were, we can just practice date, who, these things, and if we can, if you have the unique server, we can practice date, semicolon, who, greater than log file, and the difference between the parenthesis command and that command. Parenthesis means both this date and who is different command. We are combining with the semicolon and grouping with the parenthesis. So that will be, both the results should be stored in the log file, the output file named log file. I am not having any practical experience, but I executed commands very long back. Current with the project related, I can't say. If anybody knows, if I can say. You have doubt? Do you guys have doubt to this output, what it will come? Or we'll move to the next question.
Move to the next one.
Sure. What is the significance of this C command? I think it's important. They will ask the question in the interview, I think. It reads the standard input and send it to the standard output. That is the output they need. That is the answer they need. It will read the input, whatever in the file, and it sends you to the standard output. The other things are story. While rewriting the copy of what it has to read, the file specified by the user. It reads the standard input and send it to the standard file, P command. This part, it will read the input and send it to the standard output. Like say, for example, like I don't know the difference between the cat and P command. That also do the same thing, right? Cat and the thing, it will read the, it will display, then it